In the Kyrie, a contrast, the women's voices are emphasized in a representation of mourning against a backwash of string sound. The relative calm is shattered in the violent and rhythmic Sanctus. That is followed by a gentle, unaccompanied setting of the verses from Ecclesiastes, leading into the Dies Irae. And here all explodes in a mass hysteria as the wrath of God, the assassin's gun, passes judgment on mankind. A combination of screams and shouts from the choir and violent scrapings behind the bridges of the strings brings the section to a climax, and it is followed by silence. The In Paradisum progresses through major keys and uses boys' voices and tuned percussion. It's to suggest the heavenward journey of the spirit, and the work concludes with a reference to the Requiem Aeternam and the final breath of life. We'll hear the BBC Singers, the South End Boys Choir, and the BBC Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Nicholas Clewbury, in Paul Patterson's Requiem in Memory of John F. Kennedy.
Thank you. That was
Paul Patterson's Requiem in Memory of John F. Kennedy. We heard the BBC Singers, the South End Boys Choir, the BBC Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Nicholas Clearbury. It was a BBC production of that work. President Kennedy, of course, assassinated 25 years ago today. We have other programming on WFMT in memory of President Kennedy.